Hey folks, it's Dave back here playing some hockey today as, the 73-74 and 74-75 season are available for Kill the Power Play, so we're going to play some 1974 hockey with the two expansion teams, the Scouts and the Capitals, but we're going to mix it up a little bit. We're going to throw the Seals into the mix. So what I have here is a three-game set. Everybody's going to play everybody once, so we have the Scouts and the Seals kicking things off, then we'll have the Scouts and the Capitals, and finally the Capitals and the Seals, and we'll see how these three teams do against each other. I got my Scouts hat on. It's very big. As you can see, it's huge, actually, but it's the only Scouts cap I have. So to celebrate the 74-75 season coming out today, we're going to play some Scouts hockey and also some Capitals hockey. My ball roller down here, I have 2 6-sided dice at the top in blue. My percentage dice in the middle, and at the bottom, a single 10-sided dice to determine the third die modification. Again, how we play, if we use the power play goals, we have to go to the MA up here. That's the modified attack rather than the standard attack. And then you take the modified attack versus the other team's defense. And so we go F to P. We come up with K for the Seals. Between H and P is L. So that's our modified attack going into the roll. And so let's get things going here. So first things first, we're going to roll the Kansas City 10-sided die down here. And if you look up the 10-sided die in the regular season 3S, it's a 1. So we have to get a 1 to get the third die. And no for the Scouts. How about the Seals? And no for the Seals. So neither team will use the third die, so that does not come into play. So there's no new modification. We can just keep that as K and L. Now for the power plays, okay, we cross-reference again. So R to M would be O, and R to L would be O. So that's how we got the power play for each team. And what you do on the power plays, and we're going to do that right now, is we're going to roll on the scoring table, and that's going to tell me how many power play opportunities we get. Not how many goals, but how many power play opportunities. So first things first, let's go with the Scouts on column O. 12, that is fantastic. That is 4 power play opportunities for the Scouts in this game. Now let's roll for the Seals. A 4, that is not good. That is only good for 2 power play opportunities. So, yeah, so the advantage right now going to the Scouts. So now let's roll for goals. So column K, that's what we're going to do because that's our modified number here. There was no third die modification, so just a straight K. So this is how many goals minus the power play opportunities the Scouts are going to get. So the Scouts roll a 6. 6 in column K. And that's pretty good, actually. That's 2 goals. So the Scouts pick up 2 goals, regular goals in this game. Column L for the Seals. Column L. Oh, that's a 10. And that is good for 3 goals. So the Seals lead 3-2. So now we're going to roll for power play. So we get 4 power play opportunities for the Scouts. And how that works is your first roll is off of your power play percentage. The second one is off the PK for the other team. And you go back and forth. Now the Seals will be the home team in here. So if you had an odd amount, you could actually roll twice on the home, and I'll explain that 1 second. So let's just do it. So we're gonna go. It's got to be 16 or less for the first roll. A 23. Nope. So the second roll has to be 76 or higher. No. So now we go back to for number 3. Remember, we have 4 rolls. So number 3, we go back to the 16. That is no. And now the final one, because we've had an even number of attempts, we go to the PK, 76 or higher. No. So they get no power play goals, so the Seals are going to win this game. We have 2 rolls for the Seals, so let's roll them. They need 13 or less. Nope. And on the second one, it's 78 or higher. And no, so no goals for the Seals on a power play. So the final score, the California Seals, 3. The Kansas City Scouts, 2. Now, let's say the Seals, being the home team, let's say they had 3 power play opportunities, right? They would go power play, PK, and then back to power play because they're at home. If the Scouts had 3, they would go power play, PK, PK. Okay, that's the home ice advantage, is that if it's an odd number, you come back to your power play. If you're on the road, if it's an odd number, you would have to stay and roll off the penalty kill. Hopefully that made sense. All right, let's go to the next game. So the Seals take the game against the Scouts. So now the Scouts will play the Capitals. So we have two expansion teams here. So we're going to roll the bottom dice here. See if we can come up with a one. Yes, so the Scouts get the third die. How about the Capitals? Yes, they both do. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to roll the third die. And let's see what the result is. First, for the Scouts, a five. A five is add two goals to your score. So add two goals. So the Scouts are adding two goals to their final score. That is really good. Now the Capitals are going to roll on the third die table. A 10. Shift your opponent modified attack column by 2. So opponent minus 2. Okay. So the new mod, N, would drop down to L. So N goes to L. And this would stay at K. It's still an advantage, though, for the Scouts, because they're going to add two goals. So let's check our power play opportunities. So off of column Q, we're going to roll the blue dice and see how many power play opportunities the Scouts get. Oh, that's a 10. 10 off of column Q is good for 4. So they, once again, will get 4 power play opportunities. Now the Capitals off of column O. A 10 as well, and that is good for 4 opportunities. So each team has 4 opportunities. So let's roll the Scouts. The Scouts are on the road. So we're going to roll them first, looking for percentage dice. So the first roll, again, is a 16 or less. 16 or less on the percentage dice. No. Second one needs to be 72 or higher because we're reading off the penalty kill for the Capitals. Yes, they get 1 power play goal. So, sorry, that's a power play goal. And now let's roll number 3. Nope, that's higher than 16. And 23 is less than 71. So they get the 1 power play goal. And I think the last time I did the goals first, I'm doing the power plays first this time. It really doesn't matter which one you do. So we got 4 chances now for the Capitals. So 13%. Nope. 78% and higher. Nope. We're back down to 13 or lower. Nope. And we need 78 or higher. Nope, so they don't get any power play goals. So it's going to come down to our standard roll. So let's roll the 6-sided dice in column L, and we're adding 2 goals for the Scouts. Column L is 6. Column L is 6. That's 2 goals plus the 2, that's 4. Wow, it's going to be a big win, I'm pretty sure. Column K is a 4. That's not very good. It's for 1 goal. So the Scouts in the battle of the expansion teams, they take it over the Capitals 5-1. Pretty much thanks to this third die roll right here. So let's go to the final game. It is the Capitals and the Seals here in the third game of the set. So let's take a look at our third die. We're going to roll the Capitals first. They need a 1. They don't get it. The Seals need a 1, and they don't get it. So there's no third die. So the modifications will just stay the same. There's going to be K, and they're going to be O. And again, let's check our power play opportunities. So column P is a 6, and that is good for 3 opportunities for the Capitals. And then column Q for the Seals is an 8, and that is good for 4 opportunities. Okay, so now we can either roll goals first, so we can go power play goals. We can do either one. We've done it either way. It really doesn't matter. Let's roll standard goals first this time, so we'll go back to what we did in game 1. So off of column K, the blue dice. Oh, not good. 3 goals. 3 is 1 goal. Column K, 3 is 1 goal. That's not good for the Capitals. The Seals off of column Q, an 11. Oh, boy, that's a big output. That's 5 goals for the Seals. So the Seals should take this one, but still going to roll the power plays anyway. So the Capitals being on the road, and we talked about the odd power play rolls. So they will roll. The first one is off of their power play. The second one is off the Seals penalty kill. And then again, off the Seals penalty kill because it's an odd number and they're on the road. So they have to roll off the PK. But actually, this works to their advantage because they only have a 13% chance on their power play, whereas against the Seals penalty kill, there's a 25% chance. So that actually works out for them. Okay, so let's roll for power play goals. First roll for the Capitals, they need 13 or less. No, oh, they just missed it. Oh, boy. So now they need 76 or higher. No, and the last one, 76 or higher. Nope. So no power play goals. So the Capitals do not fare very well. The Seals have four power play chances. Let's give that a shot. So the first one is 13 or less. Nope. The second one, 72 or higher. Yes, they get a power play goal. So now let's go back to the power play percentage of 13 or less. No, and we go back up to the Capitals penalty kill. They have to beat that, so 72 or higher. No, so they get the one, though. So the Seals will steal this one 6-1. So let's just recap our three games here between the expansion teams and the California Seals. Back on the first game, it was the Seals beating the Scouts 3-2. And then in a matchup, a head-to-head matchup between the Capitals and the Scouts crushing the Capitals 5-1. And then lastly, the Seals beat both teams here. A nice 6-1 win over the Capitals. So the Capitals lose both games. They only score one goal in each game. The Seals actually win both. And the Scouts split is how it went. So that's some kill the power play here. The 74-75 expansion is out. Make sure you head over to sportsreplays.net and check out the Roberto Chiavini games. And I'm picking this up. I really like this game. And now I can play the Scouts. I'm real happy that 74-75 is out. So I can wear my big, big hat. Look at this. It just spins around. It's so big. It's unbelievable. Anyway, I'm Dave. Hope you like this video. Bye-bye.